the columns of the tabular analysis of the we can say tabular technique analysis. The first is serial number, or here you also write chapter number, okay, because you're going to do textbook analysis for the particular standard for science subject. For example, you have selected the sixth class for doing textbook analysis. So here you are supposed to write the first column is of serial number, or you can say the chapter number. So these are the names of the unit. So the second column will be of the names of the unit. See, the names are written 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. Then the next column will be of the core element, right? See, the core element, values, life skills, and after that, two more columns are there, categorization of the content and evaluation strategy. Okay. So, and before that, you should know about, I'm just going to move on the previous page. Yes. You can see here that objectives at upper primary level. Okay. And one column is missing in the tabular form. That column is related to objectives achieved. Okay. So first column is the serial number or the chapter number. The second is name of the unit. The third supposed to be objectives achieved. I'm going to repeat it again. Objectives achieved. Then next is core element. Then next is values. Then next is life skills. Then the categorization of the content. And the last one is evaluation strategy, which you are going to use to evaluate the particular topic. Okay. So objective means what? You can see the objectives at upper primary level. So upper primary level means which level? Yes. Yes.
6 to 8.
Very, very true. The upper primary level means 6 to 8. If you have selected 9th or 10th standard, so you have to write here objectives at secondary level, because you have selected 9th and 10th standard, or 9th or 10th standard. Okay. So whatever objectives, see, these objectives are for the particular level, and these are objective of the particular curriculum. So curriculum is always for the particular level. It can be for the primary, for the upper primary, for the secondary, or for the higher secondary. But as I requested you earlier, you have to select either 6th, 7th, 8th, and 9th textbooks for the textbook analysis. So if you have selected 6 to 8 standard, so you can write whatever objectives are displayed here, you can write the same objective. And if you have selected 9th or 10th standard textbook of science subject, then you have to select the objective for the that particular level, secondary level. Understood? Itna clear hua aapka? Yes?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Good. See, now the second column should be, after name of the unit, there should be objective achieved. Okay. So there are certain objective enlisted and objective of curriculum development, or you can say objective for the particular level, and curriculum it is for the particular level. So these are the objective of for the particular curriculum for the particular level. So here we are going to analyze. What we are going to analyze, we are going to find out that after this column, there will be the next column, that is objective achieved. So after teaching this particular unit, which objectives are going to achieve? Okay. So now I'm going, see the chapter, living world and classification of microbes. So this is the chapter. And now I'm going on the objective page. Yes. What was the name of the chapter? Yes.
Living world.
Yes. And
microbes.
Okay. So this was the chapter. So these are the different objectives for the particular level, and you can say these are the objectives for this primary, upper primary level or higher primary level, you can say. So which objectives, after teaching this particular topic, first you have to go through the textbook and you have to see the content, what kind of content and the scope of the content included for the particular standard. And on the basis of that, you can analyze these objectives. Okay. Now just read these objectives. First, see, after only seeing the name of the topic, it's not possible to analyze the objective, or it's not possible to find out which objectives will be achieved, but you can have, we can get some idea regarding that. See, to introduce the student to the primary physical, biological and chemical properties, to develop the skill and habit of accurate measurement, to reinforce the skill of performing simple experiments, okay, to reinforce the skill of observation, classification and of drawing inferences, to help students to understand the cause-effect relationship in natural incidents, to inculcate scientific attitude, okay, to create awareness about necessity of balance in nature, to make student student recognize the relationship of science, technology and society. Okay, so these are the objectives for the particular for this upper primary level. Now just after just saying the name of the topic or name of the unit or new name of the chapter, just tell me after teaching particular topic which objectives will be achieved. That is the basic thing. We should know the content, what kind of content is included for the particular standard, but we can also recognize some objectives, not all but some of them. Yes
ma'am. Fourth objective,
to reinforce the skill of observation, classification and of drawing inferences. Okay, and I want to some other responses. Yes.
Yes, ma'am. First objective,
okay, to introduce the student to the primary physical, biological and chemical properties. Okay, apart from these two objectives,
the sixth one, to inculcate a scientific,
yes,
attitude.
See, this is the very common objective, and whenever you are going to teach any topic, so this is the common objective for all the topics. Okay, because science is the subject basically to inculcate the scientific attitude among the students. So this is the common objective. Understood how to do analyze by using of the objectives. Okay, so here you have to only consider the particular chapter and just keep list of the objectives in front of you, and after seeing the content of the particular chapter, easily you can recognize which objectives will be achieved after teaching that particular chapter or the unit. Understood? Itna clear hua aapka? Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, those who are selected standard 9th or 10th, please contact me. So you will get the list of the objective, and it is given in other books also, other reference books also. So you will easily get from that also. Okay? Okay. The next is the column of core element. Okay, this is very new concept, I can say. Core element. The values, you are familiar about the values. Yes? You know the values, because nowadays value education, this is the one subject at the school level. Okay, and the life skills, and we are also teaching life skills. We are also conducting various program to teach life skills for the students. Okay, so you might have aware about these two words, the values and life skills, isn't it? Yes, you don't know anything about this, please give response.
Not very, yes, familiar, ma'am.
Okay, no problem. See, the core element. See, core element means what? See, here we are going to analyze the textbooks on the basis of the objective for the particular level, means this objective for the particular curriculum, we can say. And the core element, just take example. Now we are in Maharashtra state. And if we see the curriculum of the particular level, is it same? Is it same?
No.
It is not same. But the thing, because why it is not same? There is a variation we can see. Just compare the, we can just take an example. Suppose the curriculum for the upper primary level in Maharashtra, curriculum for upper primary level for in Bihar, we can say, in UP, in Rajasthan. Just compare, you can compare, even you can compare the same curriculum with the other boards also, because the schools, they are affiliated to the different kinds of boards. Some are the state boards, some are the central boards, and some are the international boards. Okay, so it varies. But the National Policy on Education 1986 declare, and it gives recommendation that there should be similar national curriculum. अभी नेशनल करिकुलम नेशनल पॉलिसी ऑन एजुकेशन ने तो बोल दिया कि सब जगह क्या होना चाहिए, करिकुलम सेम होना चाहिए. लेकिन इफ वी सी हमारा इंडिया कैसे, देयर इज अ डाइवर्सिटी. डाइवर्सिटी इन व्हाट कॉन्टेक्स्ट? कहाँ कहाँ पे डाइवर्सिटी है? यस
लैंग्वेज,
यस
कल्चर,
कल्चर,
सोशियो कल्चर डाइवर्सिटी, इवन द हिस्टोरिकल डाइवर्सिटी इन द लैंग्वेज इज ऑल्सो, रिलीजन वाइज डाइवर्सिटी, देर आर सो मेनी फैक्टर्स एंड यू कैन सी द डाइवर्सिटी और द वराइटीज वी कैन से. And if we see as per the need of the society, suppose, but you can take example of the particular state or the particular society, as per the need of the society, the curriculum is developed. Okay, or the, you can say the first, see, even in the curriculum, planning is there. As per the planning, curriculum is developed and there is a curriculum transaction, and the curriculum transaction, it is always done at the school level, right? So here, to keep the, what you can say, the similarity. So there should be similarity between the curriculum of all the states in the all the states for all the levels. So the recommendations given by the National Policy on Education 1986 that this curriculum should be based on, by considering the social needs or the needs of the particular region, and they have to also consider the needs of the nation. And for that, they're supposed to construct, they're supposed to plan, they're supposed to develop the curriculum on the basis of core elements. So that's the reason this, the name is core. Core means what? The meaning of this gabha bhuti, yani bahut hi jisko important, jo main center pe hai aur jo bahut jyada important hai, that is core. Okay, so name is core element. So the entire curriculum is based on this core element. See, I'm telling you, this is about the curriculum, this is not about the textbook. But while teaching the particular subject or as a science teacher, you should know how to inculcate these different core elements through your teaching among the students. Okay, and total 10 core elements they have enlisted, and 10 even the 10 values, we'll tell you about the values later. So 10 core elements, they are enlisted. Just I'm going to tell the names of the core elements. Please listen carefully. History of India's freedom movement, constitutional obligations, content essential to nurture national identity, India's common cultural heritage, egalitarianism, democracy and secularism. So egalitarianism, that is nothing but the equality. You can say equality, democracy and secularism. Then again, the next is equality of sexes, then protection of environment, removal of social barriers, observance of small family norms, and the last is inculcation of scientific tempo. Okay, so these are the 10 core elements. Just wait for a minute. You can see here, so these are the 10. After only typing core elements, we cannot, we will not get the particular actual content. See, the history of India's freedom movement, constitutional obligations, then content essential to nurture international identity, India's common cultural heritage. Okay, so these are the 10 core elements, and the entire curriculum for any level, it can be primary, higher primary, secondary, higher secondary, the entire curriculum. Again and again, I'm repeating the word curriculum, not the textbook. Okay, so the entire curriculum is framed on the basis of the core element. Okay, and it was
explained. Ma'am, I have a doubt.
Yes,
ma'am, these 10 core elements, are they related to history? I'm not talking about the textbook, but is this related to history, what you just told?
No. See, actually, these are the basic core element and the entire the curriculum. So maybe there are different study of different subject. There are some study of different other activities. Okay, so the entire curriculum, do you understand the curriculum? Curriculum means what? The study of subject and as well as the other activities, extracurricular activities are also included in the curriculum. Okay, so the entire activities of the entire curriculum is planned on the basis of these 10 core elements. Okay, and these are the recommendations given by the National Policy on Education 1986. So firstly, whenever we are seeing that your question was very correct, because after listening these core elements, firstly what we can see that yes, is it these most of the core elements, they are related to the history and the civic subject, right? But it's not like that, because as a teacher, it's our duty to correlate our subject with this core element, and it is not possible that all the 10 core elements are included in the science subject. Maybe some of them are included, or you can say related to the science subject, and in the textbook analysis you are going to find out which core element is hidden in that particular content, or you can, while teaching that particular content, how we can correlate the actual teaching content with the core element, right? So we'll take example. Okay, for example, we'll start with the first core element, that is history of India's freedom movement. We'll start with this, it's history of India's freedom movement. Okay, so as you all know, so we had to struggle to gain freedom from the British, and so many freedom fighters, so we can say so many leaders, they have sacrificed a lot for getting freedom from British. Okay, so here the basically the students, if we see the objective, the student, they should have knowledge about the India's freedom movement. They should understand the values that emerged through the freedom movement. Okay, and see, this is not only regarding the freedom, but here we have to consider, the history, it includes love for the freedom and in all respect. Okay, so whenever we are going to teach as I told you that it is not possible that all the core elements, I'm telling you that entire curriculum is framed on the basis of these core elements. Not only the science subject is framed on the basis of all the core elements. Here it's our duty to find out which core element is related to the particular topic related to science subject. Okay. So here we want the freedom. Freedom for what? Yes. We should have love for the freedom. हमें फ्रीडम चाहिए. हम दिस इज द डेमोक्रेटिक कंट्री, हमें फ्रीडम चाहिए. फ्रीडम किस चीज के लिए चाहिए? यस, सो फ्रीडम टू फाइट अगेंस्ट इनजस्टिस. ओके, सो इनका ये कहना है कि ऐसे जो भी कोर एलिमेंट्स है, आप करिकुलम में ऐसे कुछ प्लान करो जिसकी वजह से ये जो भी कोर एलिमेंट्स है वो बच्चों में इनकल्केट हो जाए. ओके, so this is about, so basically if we see the history of India's freedom movement, so basically this is related to the history subject. This is not much related to the science subject. Okay, but there are certain other core elements, they are related, we can relate those core element with the science subjects. So let's take the example, that is the constitutional obligations. Okay, the constitutional obligation means what? So we are having certain rules and regulations for the smooth functioning of the nation. Okay, and here what we can say here, the every citizen has to realize that the constitution it gives us right, and which tells us about what are our duties towards the nation. Okay, and it gives what you can say, constitution also reflect expectations and awareness of the citizens. So how we can correlate this particular core element with the science subject?
Yes,
basically just keep in mind that it tells, as a citizen, constitution tells us about the what are the rules and regulations, and what are, as a good citizen of the nation, what are our duties. Okay, so how we can correlate this particular core element with the particular topic? Yes, yes, for example, certain topics are there in the science subject, like natural resources, for example, some units like water, soil, even the what you can say, animal husbandry. So these are the certain topics, even the components of atmosphere. So as a good citizen, we have to explain, it's our duty that we have to explain our students that what are our duties and responsibilities. First, for example, suppose you are going to teach the topic water. So at that, we can tell the students about the how to avoid the water pollution. So what is our duty? What is our role? Okay, to prevent the water pollution. So we have to find out particular. We have to analyze the topic. What is the content over there, and how we can correlate that particular topic with the particular core elements. So like that, you have to find out the different core elements which are hidden in the particular unit. Understood about this? Yes.
In case of the topic of, say, the water, sources of water or water, we can say that the core element is protection of environment.
Yes, see. Yes,
as
yes.
Well as scientific inculcation, yes. Of a scientific temper. So there will be two.
Yes. See, okay. it is not necessary that only the one core element should be there, the two core elements. It depends.
More than one core element,
yes,
involved.
Yes, more than one. Okay. See, so basically, the scientific inculcation of the scientific temper, it is common for all the chapters. Okay. Write it blindly. Yes. And apart from that, you have to find out.
Inculcation of scientific temper is common for every chapter in the science textbook.
Yes.
Correct.
The next is, see, most of the time, whenever we are seeing the all the 10 core elements, so what we can feel that the protection of environment and the final, that is the inculcation of the scientific temper, these are the only two core elements. They are related to the science subject. But actually, it's not like that. Here we have to find out how we can correlate that particular core element with the actual teaching content or actual teaching of the particular chapter. So it's the duty of the teacher. It is expected while framing the curriculum, it is expected from the teacher. Okay. But unfortunately, later on, there was not proper implication of the core elements while teaching in the classroom by the teachers. And for that, there is the emergence of the new subject, that is nothing but the value education. And in value education also, it is expected that, so like this, these are the 10 core elements. So they are the 10 core values. And after studying that particular subject, the 10 core values should be inculcated among the pupils or among the students. Understood? Yes?
Yes, ma'am. Clear. Yeah.
Okay. Suppose the third is content essential to nurture. Recall the nurture national identity. Okay. So national identity means what? So there are certain symbols.
Like
there are certain symbols you can say, in India there is a diversity, there is a cultural diversity, but there are certain national things.
Okay.
So students should know, it is necessary for the student to know about the national anthem, to about the national flag, to know about the national animals, national birds, okay, and also about the national motto. Means there is a variety, there is a variation, but we are Indians and we have our national identity. So as for the topic, we can correlate your topic with the particular core element. Suppose we'll give example of, suppose you are going to teach the parts of flowers, okay, or you are going to teach about the classification. So at that time also, we can just correlate whenever you are going to teach the parts of plants, you can move on the flowers and which is the national flower. Okay, so like that, you can integrate or you can correlate your particular topic with this core element, that is content essential to nurture national identity. Okay, understood about this? Even there are certain other topics also. Can you name, can you give me some names of some topics? For example, see, national identity, for example, natural resources. Okay, the topic is natural resources and the and their protection. So how we can correlate these natural resources and their protection with the national identity? Yes. Means we have to tell them out there is a something common for all.
It comes with the protection of the environment, the national identity part.
Okay.
How it can be preserved and protected.
Okay. See, whenever you are talking about that, how it should be preserved. So here, this same thing we can also correlate with the previous correlation, that is constitutional obligations, because as a citizen, you have to follow certain duties, and as a good citizen, it's our duty to protect our environment. So again, we can correlate that particular chapter with the previous correlation, that is constitutional obligations. Understood about this? It's your creativity, how you can correlate the particular chapter or the particular unit with the core elements. Understood?
Yes.
Okay. Then next is the equality, democracy, and secularism. Okay. So, see, this core element is for the curriculum planning and the development. So here, it is not possible to correlate this particular core element while teaching in the classroom. But suppose, as a science teacher, if you are going to construct any association, we can say the science association or the science club. So for that, you can elect the students, or you can elect the members for the science association by using the democratic procedure. See, you understood what I'm saying you? Yes. यहाँ पे हमें क्या करना है कि हर एक बार ये पॉसिबल नहीं है कि आप हर एक जो भी कोर एलिमेंट है उसको थ्रू टीचिंग आप उसको इनकल्केट करें, बिकॉज दिस एंटायर करिकुलम इज फ्रेम्ड ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ ऑल दिस 10 कोर एलिमेंट्स. सो यहाँ पे एज अ साइंस टीचर इफ वी हैव टू इनकल्केट दिस इक्वालिटी, डेमोक्रेसी, सेक्युलरिज्म. सपोज यू आर going to construct the science association. Okay, and for that you can elect the members. Suppose the 10 members are there, so you can show the equality. You can select the same numbers, means 5 girls and 5 boys. Okay, so that is nothing but the equality. You are giving equal chance to each gender. Okay, I'm not going to consider the transgender, only 2 genders I'm going to consider. And if that gender is also available, you can also elect that the another gender. Okay, means everyone should get same chances for the selection. This is the one thing. We are using the democratic way. Okay, so like that, we can also use this core element, not actually in the teaching, but whenever you are going to conduct any other activity regarding our subject. So for that, we can use this core element, and we can merge this core element. Okay. Then next is the equality of sexes. There should not be biasness, no biasness on the basis of gender. Okay. So how we can correlate this equality of sexes core element with the topics? Yes. For example, suppose there is a topic balanced diet. How we can correlate this equality of sexes with the topic balanced diet? Yes. Just try to think. See, this is the equality of sexes. How can just correlate this equality of sexes with the balanced diet? Yes. See, suppose we'll take even examples of mathematics. So whenever we are going to teach mathematics, and there is a the final output should be the LHS is equal to RHS, means left hand side is equal to right hand side, means left hand side is equal to right hand side. So here both the sides are equal. So like that, always the boys and girls, they are equal. So here what we are doing, we are correlating mathematics subject, okay, with this core element, that is equality of sexes. That is the one example. So in case of diet, for example, balanced diet. Okay. So do you really think that the balanced diet, it varies gender wise? Yes. Yes.
No, ma'am.
So like that you can correlate. So actually whenever you are going to teach at that time, it is expected that the teacher should tell about this. Okay. So whenever it's a balanced diet, so girls are having different balanced diet, it is different for the boys. It's not like that, it is same for the, means everyone should have the balanced diet. Okay. So like that you can correlate the particular topic with the core element. The next is the protection of environment. So there are many topics in the science subject, and mostly the inculcation of the scientific temper and this protection of environment, these are the two most appropriate, what we can say, appropriate core elements related to our subject. Okay. So many things are there, like related to the, for example, social health, soil erosion, germination topic is there, air, water, balance in nature, even the man-made products, organization of living things, the topics related to atmosphere, related to food, related to health. So many topics are there in the science subject which are related to this core element, that is protection of environment. Okay. Then the next is removal of social barrier. Okay, there are so many things on the basis of which we can include in the social barrier, like poverty is there, literacy is there, illiteracy is there. So there should not be discrimination in even in the student's mind also on the basis of all these factors. So it's teacher's job to look into this core element, that such kind of values should be inculcated among the students. So again, for example, whenever we are teaching the topic like shelter of living things, okay, so here everyone needs shelter. It can be any living things. Okay, so every living thing, it needs the shelter. So it's our duty to correlate this particular topic with the core element, that is removal of social. It doesn't matter whether that particular person is poor or rich. It doesn't matter whether that particular person is literate or illiterate, whether that particular person is staying in the urban area or in the rural area, whether that particular person is male or female, or it's a transgender. It doesn't matter, because shelter is needed by every living organism. So like that, we have to correlate while teaching the particular unit. You have to correlate. See, this is very important for you, because whenever you are going to teach any topic for your practice teaching and even the internship, for that also you have to write on, if you see the lesson note on the front page, you're supposed to write which core elements are related to that particular topic, even the values and life skills are related to that particular topic. Then the next is observance of small family norms. Actually, you know, the population, it goes on increasing day by day, and you can say now there is a population explosion, and it is having very bad effect on the nature, on us also. So this is one core element that from the beginning also hame unke dimag mein se dalna hai ki small family ke family kyun hona zaruri hai uske hamare country pe ya fir hamara nature pe kaise uska diverse effect hota hai, ye starting se hi hame unko batana hai. So the things related to, see, so there are different topics like life processes, even the animal husbandry, even the functions of life, so even the hygiene topic is there. Okay, so these are the so many topics. Sir, abhi ye corona ki wajah se abhi bhi dekh sakte ho ki isolation mein nahi rakh sakte. Kyun? Because of the population, 5 to 6 people, they are staying in the 10 by 10 room, 10 by 10 ke room mein 5-6 log rehte hain, to wahan pe isolate kaise karenge. ओके, इवन अभी भी बहुत सारे कोविड सेंटर्स, अभी तो ठीक है उनके ऑक्सीजन फैसिलिटी अवेलेबल नहीं है, लेकिन बहुत सारे ऐसी भी चीजें वहाँ पे वैकेंसीज नहीं है, बेड ही खाली नहीं है. ठीक, क्यों हो रहा है? इट्स ओनली बिकॉज ऑफ द पॉपुलेशन. पॉपुलेशन इतना ज्यादा है, अगर ये पॉपुलेशन कम होता तो शायद वहाँ पे जो भी रिसोर्सेज चाहिए वो हमें अवेलेबल हो जाते. तो स्टार्टिंग से ही, क्योंकि बच्चे क्या है, फ्यूचर सिटीजन है, और बाद में बोलते ना कि प्रोग्रेस करना इन केस ऑफ पॉपुलेशन आल्सो उन्हीं के हाथ में है. तो स्टार्टिंग से ही उनमें ये पहले से ये करना है कि स्मॉल फैमिली होने के फायदे क्या है और उसके नुकसान क्या है. ओके, सो दिस इज द वन कोर एलिमेंट फॉर द करिकुलम, करिकुलम प्लानिंग, एंड इट शुड बी, द टीचर शुड इनकल्केट दिस कोर एलिमेंट व्हाइल टीचिंग इन द क्लासरूम while teaching the science subject. Okay. And the last thing is the inclusion of the scientific temper. It is related to all the topics. Okay. So scientific temper means what? So basically, the inculcation of the scientific temper, and it is necessary for the student to help them to acquire the habit of thinking in a specific manner and receiving some information. And they also are also making habit of whatever they are saying, that statement should have the proofs. जो भी है वो सही है उसका कुछ प्रूफ होना चाहिए. दे आर स्टार्टिंग इन द स्पेसिफिक मैनर. ओके, दैट इज नथिंग बट द साइंटिफिक टेम्पर. एंड दिस इंकलकेशन ऑफ द साइंटिफिक टेम्पर, दिस इज द कोर एलिमेंट. इट इज रिलेटेड टू ऑल द टॉपिक्स ऑफ साइंस सब्जेक्ट. सो ब्लाइंडली यू कैन राइट दिस इंकलकेशन ऑफ द साइंटिफिक टेम्पर. अंडरस्टूड अबाउट द कोर एलिमेंट्स? यस
यस मैम.
पहले से ये दिमाग से आप निकाल दो कि 10 के 10 कोर एलिमेंट आपको साइंस में मिलेंगे. ऐसे नहीं होगा. ये आपकी रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी है कि जब आप कंटेंट को एनालाइज करोगे, ठीक है, बिकॉज सपोज सो मेनी टॉपिक्स आर देयर, द सेम टॉपिक्स आर एट द 6th स्टैंडर्ड, 7th स्टैंडर्ड, 8th स्टैंडर्ड, बट द स्कोप इज डिफरेंट. सो एज पर द स्कोप, इट्स योर ड्यूटी टू फाइंड आउट विच इज द एप्रोप्रिएट कोर एलिमेंट फॉर द पर्टिकुलर टॉपिक. सो लाइक दैट यू आर गोइंग टू डू a textbook analysis on the basis of core elements. Understood? It is clear? Okay, so these are the hidden things. Aapko ye kahi pe bhi nahi milega. Of course, aapko khali wo books mein likha hua. So these are the 10 core elements. But no one, koi bhi teacher aise nahi hai jo iske upar bahut hi kam rahenge. Usme 0.12% mein wo aayenge ki jo isko dekh ke वो पहले से ही बोलते हैं. वाइल टीचिंग इन द क्लासरूम दे आर टेकिंग केयर ऑफ ऑल दिस कोर एलिमेंट एंड इवन वाइल कंडक्टिंग डिफरेंट एक्टिविटीज ऑल्सो. ऐसे नहीं हो रहा है. सो बिकॉज ऑफ दैट, अगेन नेशनल पॉलिसी ऑन एजुकेशन, दे आर रिकमेंडेड द न्यू सब्जेक्ट दैट शुड बी टॉट टू द स्टूडेंट, दैट इज द वैल्यू एजुकेशन. एंड अगेन दे आर एनलिस्टेड द डिफरेंट वैल्यूज. एंड द वैल्यूज, यू आर वेरी फैमिलियर अबाउट द वैल्यूज. आई एम जस्ट गोइंग टू And we can see, we can divide the values. Some values are the personal values, some values are the social values, and some values are the national values. Okay. And values means what? That we can say that is something that can be aspired or followed. Okay. So we are going to divide the values: personal values, social values, national values. But just keep this division aside, because whenever you are going to write analysis regarding the core values, you have to consider the different values. See what comes under the personal values: punctuality, neatness, dignity for labor, scientific attitude. Again, scientific attitude means scientific way of thinking. So this is common for all the chapters. So blindly you can write in the core element, blindly you can write the inculcation of the scientific temper, and in case of values, blindly you can write scientific attitude for each and every chapter. Okay. Then what comes under the social values? Modesty, gender equality, sensitivity, tolerance towards all religions, and under the national values, patriotism and national integrity. So these are the total 10 values: 4 under personal values, 4 under social values, and 4 under national values. So total 10 values are there, and it is also it is also job of a teacher. So though there is a subject that is value education, but while teaching in the classroom, teacher should try to inculcate all these values, personal, social, and national values among the students. So in the analysis, textbook analysis also, after analyzing the content part, you are going to find out, so after teaching this, while teaching this particular topic, which values it is related to, which value. It can be personal, it can be social, it can be national, or sometimes there is a merging of more than two values. Okay, understood about this? Yes students,
clear ma'am.
Yes, we'll give you one example. For example, gender equality, so we can correlate this with the equality of sexes, right? So both are same, because core element ka proper inculcation nahi hua, isliye unhone values, jo bhi core values hai, उनको कंपलसरी किया थ्रू वैल्यू एजुकेशन एट एवरी लेवल. ओके, सो फॉर एग्जांपल जेंडर इक्वालिटी कैसे हो सकती है, मैं बताती हूँ आपको. सपोज एज अ साइंस टीचर, इफ यू आर गोइंग टू हेल्ड एनी कंपटीशन, फॉर एग्जांपल यू आर गोइंग टू हेल्ड एनी ऐसी कंपटीशन, द स्पीच कंपटीशन, So for that, you should give equal chance to girls and boys. So that is nothing but the gender equality. Even while conducting experiments also, बहुत बार ऐसे होता है कि if teacher is going to do demonstration in the class, so at the time, the teacher is calling someone or two volunteers. So at that time, suppose for taking help, so for the first experiment, you can call the girl, for the second, for the boy, or sometimes you call one girl and one boy at a time. Okay, so this is about the gender equality. Even as I gave you the example of democracy, that is electing the members for the science association. So for that also, you can give the equal numbers for the girls and boys. Suppose you are going to elect the 10 numbers, so five numbers for the girls, which is 5 numbers from girls and 5 from the boys. So this is about the gender equality. Okay, then I'm not giving all the examples. Okay, I'm just giving some examples, but it is not possible. This is very wide topic, and definitely I will provide you some notes, so you'll get idea about this. For next is that is the suppose the sensitivity. So as a teacher, how can plan the activities to bring this sensitivity value among the student? Yes, so can you tell me? Yes, students. It's regarding the sensitivity. I'm not telling you that it is possible to inculcate all the values through teaching. So there are some values we are going to taught by taking some other activities related to our subject. Yes. See, nowadays there.
Ma'am, can you please repeat the question again?
Okay, the value that is the sensitivity value. Okay, so it is not possible for us to teach this sensitivity value among the students in the classroom teaching, but the teacher is also taking some other activities. Okay, and by taking other activities, of course, you can inculcate this value, that is the sensitivity value. So can you tell me which activities you can use for inculcating this value?
Example of mimosa plant.
Yes.
But we can take the example of mimosa plant.
Can you explain, please?
Ma'am, when we touch by response of stimuli, it shrink, closes when we are touching it.
Okay, how you can correlate with this sensitivity value? The sensitivity means that is, see, you give the example, but here we are going to
enter
the value. Yes, please.
Chemical reactions, at the time of chemical reaction, yes, to chemical, that time sensitivity to how's the color, how's the smell.
Okay, so these are the topic so these are the examples were related to the actual teaching of the content, right? Now tell me the examples, tell me the activities which you can took for this particular value inculcation. बहुत बार ऐसे होता है कि अगर बच्चों को आप गार्डनिंग के लिए लेके गए, तो जब भी बच्चे खुद प्लांटेशन करते हैं, वो टाइम पे वो कभी आप वहाँ पे देखोगे, जब भी वो खुद कोई भी पौधा खुद लगाते हैं, तो ऑटोमेटिकली कि फूल नहीं तोड़ने चाहिए, पत्ते नहीं तोड़ने चाहिए, ठीक है, मतलब ये जो भी है, सो दे आर वेरी सेंसिटिव अबाउट द नेचर, सो ऑटोमेटिकली ये जो सेंसिटिविटी वैल्यू है उनमें इनकल्केट हो जाता है. तो वो फ्लावर्स नहीं तोड़ेंगे, जो भी पत्ते हैं वो नहीं तोड़ेंगे. कभी कभी कुछ बच्चों को आदत होती है पौधे खींचने की, उनको निकालने की आदत होती है, वो उनमें नहीं रहती. ओके, सो दीज आर द डिफरेंट एग्जांपल्स. ऑफ कोर्स योर एग्जांपल्स वर आल्सो राइट, द एग्जांपल्स वर रिलेटेड टू द एक्चुअल टीचिंग टॉपिक. ओके, एंड एक्चुअल टीचिंग इन द क्लासरूम कंडीशन, बट दीज आर द एग्जांपल्स लाइक गार्डनिंग. सो दिस इज द एग्जांपल. द अदर एक्टिविटी द साइंस टीचर शुड टेक, again I am telling you, so entire thing is related to the curriculum, not related to the particular subject or not related to the textbook. Okay, understood? Then what about the punctuality? Yes, how we can inculcate this value as a science teacher, how we can inculcate this value among the student? Yes. And one more, I'm expecting one more example from you regarding the value that is neatness. Yes. try to explain. Yes, students. Yes, students. Punctuality. See, again, most of the time, see, the teachers are the role models for the students, and they are learning such kind of values from the teachers also. Okay. For example, suppose as a science teacher, if you are going to conduct the practical in the laboratory, at that time, the teacher should be punctual. They should come in time. So whatever activity is given to the student, they have to complete the activities because there is a time slot. So they have to complete the certain activity within the given time. Even the what you can say, the teacher should take the attendance for the daily period also, attendance during the laboratory work also. Okay, so if the teacher is punctual, automatically the students, they are going to imitate the teacher. And the same thing is related to the next value, that is the neatness. Suppose the teacher, if the teacher is very, very what you can say, presenting himself or herself very properly, and whenever he is going to write anything on the blackboard, going to draw any figure on the blackboard, so he is going to draw anything very neatly, very keenly. Even the writing part, it is also appropriate and accurate. So automatically the students, they are learning the same thing from the teacher. Okay. So by using such kind of activity, the teacher can inculcate the values among the students. Okay. So in case of values, the values, most of the values related to our subject, and the values are the scientific activity, it is a very common value. Then the sensitivity, that is the next one, the national integrity, gender equality, and we can say the dignity for labor, that is also. So these are the values which we can inculcate among the student by teaching the science subject. Okay, understood about the values? Don't worry, I will provide you nice notes regarding these values and core elements, because it is there in your syllabus also. Okay, and it will help you for the practice teaching also. Okay, and the next is, that is the life skills. The life skill means what? Our abilities for adaptive and positive behavior that enable individuals to deal effectively with the demands and challenges of everyday life. That's why the name is life skills, the skills necessary for the life. Okay. So the life skills, there are 10 life skills given by the UNESCO and WHO, that is World Health Organization. And the life skills are, so these are the 10, I think one is missing here. And the last one is coping with the stress, or you can say the stress management, that is the last life skill. And this total 10 life skills, I think you all are familiar with these life skills. These are very common. And I think in the second year, next year you are having the practical for this on the life skills, okay? So decision making, creative thinking, critical thinking, problem solving, negotiation skills, interpersonal relationships, self-awareness, empathy, effective communication, and last is coping with the stress. So these are the 10 life skills. So again, you are going to do the same thing. You have to find out any activity. You have to analyze the content. And on the basis of that, you have to find out which life skills you are going to inculcate among the students on the basis of the whatever content is there for the particular chapter. Okay, understood about the life skills? I'm not going to explain, because I think you all are familiar with this, and so much content is available on the net also, so you'll get idea about the each life skills, because we have very less time. Actually the time is exceeded, I think. Yes, students?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, and just wait for a minute. See, the core element column is done, values are done, life skills are done. The next is the categorization and the evaluation strategy. So categorization, see, in the first lecture we have learned about the product. So while categorizing the content, first you have to write about the product. So for example, certain definitions are there. So write the definitions of what? Okay, then the characteristics, the properties, laws, and then you can write about the classification, about the need, about the different subtopics you can write. Okay, so in the categorization, you have to write about the main products. I'm going to repeat, you have to write about the main products. The science, it is the process and product is always the accurate and correct knowledge that is nothing but the product, and which is always in the form of laws, theories, principles, concepts, theorems, etc. So first you have to write that, and the remaining subtopics you can write below that. Okay, so that is nothing but the categorization of the content. And the last, evaluation strategy, means for the particular unit which evaluation strategy you are going to follow. It depends on the particular unit, you have to find out the evaluation strategy. It's up to you. You can use certain new innovative evaluation strategies also. It's up to you, it's your choice. Okay, so I think you understood about the tabular textbook analysis. Yes, yes, students. Yes. please respond. Or still you are having query regarding this, if you are having any query, you can ask me personally also, or in the science group also. Yes, the topic is clear to you?
Yes ma'am, to some extent. If any doubt will be there, we'll contact.
Categorization of content, what you said will come, ma'am. Sorry to cut you.
Categorization of the content means, here first you're supposed to write, see, the science, it is in the form of product. So product, right? So while categorizing the content, you have to find out first what is the product there. Okay, so product, it is in the form of definitions, in the form of concept. For example, hard and soft odor. So these are the two concepts. Okay, so many definitions are there, like pollutions, like microbes means what. So you have to find, first you have to write about about the product, about the laws, about the theorem, about the principle. Okay, and then whatever subtopics are related to that particular unit, you can write the subtopics below that.
Okay.
Okay, so this is nothing but the categorization of the content. And for particular chapter, which evaluation strategy you are going to use. So there are so many techniques nowadays we are using. Don't stick to only oral written, and you can write about the particular thing. Oral written, it's okay. But what kind of written test you are going to conduct? Okay. What about the practical?
Whether it is going to be written like an MCQ, like that?
Yes. So okay. You can just write it, what you can say, specifically you can write. Okay. See, this is very wide topic. Actually, we have very less time. So I asked Vikas sir, I want one lecture on first year, because basically I am the teacher of second year. So मैंने उनसे मांग लिया कि मुझे एक चाहिए, क्योंकि बच्चों के क्वेरीज है, उनको नहीं आएगा ये सब. तो इसके लिए देखो, आपके जब प्रैक्टिस टीचिंग का आपका ओरिएंटेशन रहेगा, तो वहाँ पे कोर एलिमेंट वैल्यूज लाइफ स्किल के अलग अलग लेक्चर्स रहेंगे. लेकिन यहाँ पे क्या हो गया, थोड़ा टाइम प्रॉपर नहीं हुआ है, सभी चीज़ें एक्टिविटीज ऑन टाइम नहीं हो रही है बिकॉज ऑफ द लेट एडमिशन प्रोसीजर. सो ये आपको नहीं पता है, ठीक है? तो आपको इसके बारे में अभी भी आपको कुछ क्वेरी आती है, यू कैन आस्क मी पर्सनली, यू कैन आस्क मी ऑन द साइंस ग्रुप ऑल्सो. अगर आपकी एक की कुछ क्वेरीज है और बाकी लोगों को भी सेम क्वेरीज है, तो वहीं पे उनकी सभी की क्वेरी सॉल्व हो जाएंगी, ठीक है? ओके, अंडरस्टूड? आई थिंक यू अंडरस्टूड, नॉट 100%, बट आई थिंक 70-80% यू अंडरस्टूड अबाउट दिस टॉपिक. यस और नो? यस
यस मैम.
आप पहले करो, जब भी आप टेबुलर टेक्स्टबुक एनालिसिस करोगे, तभी आपको समझ में आएगा आपका अंडरस्टैंडिंग कितना होगा, ठीक है? आप करो, और करने के बाद आपको कुछ क्वेरीज आती है तो आप उसको वो मुझे पूछ सकते हो, ठीक है? ओके, मैं आपके ये जो मेरे पास जो भी नोट्स है रिगार्डिंग फॉर लाइफ स्किल, यू विल गेट मटेरियल ऑन द नेट, बट फॉर रिगार्डिंग द कोर वैल्यूज एंड कोर एलिमेंट, वी विल पोस्ट द मटेरियल ऑन द साइंस ग्रुप. ओके, सो इट विल हेल्प यू टू अंडरस्टैंड द कंटेंट ऑल्सो, एंड टू फाइंड आउट द पर्टिकुलर कोर एलिमेंट्स एंड वैल्यूज हिडन इन द पर्टिकुलर यूनिट. ओके
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, thank you so much. I think it's time exceed. It's 12:32 now, and I think Bert ma'am, she's having lecture. Okay, so thank you so much. Please take care of yourself and your family. See you in the next lecture.
Thank you.
Thank you. Bye bye.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.